on our channel. My name is Amara.
And my name is Gospel.
Now today we also want to have another conversation. So you know we have a series of conversations. Today we want to talk about compatibility tests. What exactly, you know the word compatibility, a lot of people talk about that, we're not compatible. What exactly do they mean when they say that?
I think compatibility is about how you get along with someone at different levels. And today we'll be looking at those levels or aspects of compatibility. The first one we want to look at is spiritual compatibility. This is very, very crucial. In fact, of all the compatibility tests we want you to look at, this one is the most important. Before you decide to settle
with someone,
you have to ask yourself, who is this person? What is this person's purpose? What is this person's values and beliefs about God, spirituality,
faith?
You know, how would this person align? How would this person's values and all those align
with your value? Yeah, I think this is very important because we also need to think about the fact that this is an integral part of human existence.
Yeah, spirituality is a very core essence of our being.
Yes, spirituality is actually an integral part of our human existence. And you need to understand where the person aligns him or herself.
This whole thing. Yes. Yeah. Spirituality, in fact, it is who we are. It is what makes us who we are. You can't isolate someone from the person's belief. Whether you believe in God, you are an atheist, or you believe in, many people believe in something.
Yes.
That's what we know. So before you decide to get married to that person, know what the person believes and see if what the person believes
aligns
with what you believe.
Or else this might be a potential point of conflict in your relationship.
When we talk about spirituality, you need to know that it is beyond being part of one's religious organization. Someone can be in the same organization with you, but you have different levels or thinking or perspective about spirituality. So your ideology may not be the same, even though you have common grounds in terms of religion. It's not even religious activities. It could be religious activities could be an expression of one's spirituality, but it's not the fundamental for knowing who is spiritual or not.
So I would say at this point that it is wrong for you to assume that you have similar beliefs and values with someone like you. In fact, it should be something you discuss. The fact that someone is a Christian doesn't mean that they share the same principles, that they share the same belief with you. So you really need to have a sit-down conversation to understand what exactly is your belief and your value as it has to do with spirituality, as it has to do with God, before you get into the point of contemplating marriage.
Yeah, we always emphasize that in fact, the entry point to relationship or intimate relationship is knowing someone's spiritual values.
Yeah.
Before you step on to get emotionally attached to the person. In fact, if there is no common ground, then you guys are not compatible.
You know, following up from what you said, I just want to add that if your vision does not transcend beyond your personal needs, which should be the focus of your marital relationship, you are not spiritually compatible.
And you're not spiritually mature.
Yes. So I would say that a lot of people in a relationship, should actually sit down to have this conversation around what exactly is our purpose. And if our purpose is all about, it's very divergent, then it's a problem.
Yes. Yeah. Why we are making this emphasis is because we understand marriage to be bigger than the two people involved.
Yes.
Marriage is a means to an end. So you need to be sure of that end before you start up. If not, when you get married to someone whose spiritual beliefs and values contradict yours, trust me, it's going to end in frustration because you want to point your life to point A and the person is talking point B. That becomes a serious area or point for conflict.
Yeah, and I think that people in a relationship should think about what exactly would my relationship, or how can we synergize in order to achieve something that is beyond our daily survival need, that is bigger than what we need from a day to day. And I think that this is something that needs serious conversation around. And you just have to be honest with yourself, because we have seen a lot of marital relationship in having problems, and spirituality is one point of conflict in some of these relationships. The next compatibility test that we want to touch about is emotional compatibility. Emotional compatibility is reflected in your ability to feel affectionate and connected with each other.
Yeah.
Now, some couples, they seem to radiate this without effort. I mean, effortlessly. The feeling of happiness that when they are together, it shows. They share a sense of freedom to be real, to be authentic, with each other.
Yeah.
And, you know, you just look at them and they seem like best friends.
Yeah.
So you have that feeling of safety. Mm-hmm. You have that feeling of warmth when you're with each other.
That's what emotional connection is about.
Yes.
When you're connected with someone that makes you feel to yourself, feel real.
Yes.
Yourself, your warmth when you're around that person.
Yes.
So you have to go through that test to see this person you're in a relationship with.
Yeah.
How do you feel about it? How connected are you with this person? Can you be yourself with this person? Is this person like a friend to you? Or do you feel uneasy?
Are uptight, constantly trying to rehearse what you want to say, and you're not like being yourself with that person. I think that that relationship, I smell a rat. It's not supposed to be, because this is one special person in your life, and you should be yourself with that one person. The thing is that at the start of the relationship, some people don't feel that connection emotionally with someone. But I would say that before you get down, and you know, sometimes it takes time. It takes time for someone to come around and really like, is this someone I really care about? Is this someone I can be real with? Is this someone I can be authentic with? Because some people have been through series of issues in previous relationships.
And they are so closed off that they don't have that freedom
expression.
Or willingness to open up.
Exactly.
So that someone can have access to them.
Yeah, so they're kind of being protective about themselves or how they feel about themselves. Now, I mean, you could give it time.
Yeah.
But I would say that primarily, please make sure that your mind, you actually in your mind, you're settled about this before you go on to settle down with that individual. It is important to be sure of your level of emotional
compatibility before you settle for marriage.
For whoever, I don't know, this is the key point actually. So how emotionally compatible are you with that person? I know these are nutshells, like bullet points that we are saying, but basically what that means is check to see if you are real with this person. There's a lot of relationships out there where the individuals in that relationship are not real. In fact,
they're not themselves.
You don't even know that person, because that person only shows you a part of what they want you to believe or what they want you to see. So you have to get to the point where you're real with someone. And if you feel that you cannot be secure in that relationship or being real with that person or being authentic with that person, I don't think you should carry on with that relationship. That means like you're not emotionally compatible with that person.
That ties to previous episode we did on test of time.
Yes.
So one of the ways to prove whether you're compatible emotionally or not is to allow time in your relationship. Now, looking at it, we want to look at the next area of compatibility, which is intellectual compatibility.
Wow.
Intellectual compatibility has to do with your ability to engage in meaningful conversation with this person at an intellectual level where there is, you know, this commonality in terms of the way you flow when you talk with this person.
About issues.
In fact, it's not even about education, you know, because when you say intellectual compatibility,
a lot of people think education.
Academics.
No,
it's not what it is. Even though education is important because it helps you broaden your scope or your perspective to world, you know, your world view.
Yes. You know? So it kind of gives you a broader view, a platform for that to be broadened. But I don't think that academic qualification should be
a yardstick to measure if someone is intellectually compatible with you or not.
Yes.
I think the core thing here is having someone that you guys have similar exposure.
Yes.
Similar reference point.
Yes.
You have a lot of things you can talk about.
Yes.
And be yourself in terms of communication.
Absolutely.
And flow well.
Exactly. Mm. And I just want to say that, you know, this is more about your level of exposure to information and your understanding and application of such knowledge. Mm. Because some people are not quite informed. Mm. And I think this creates a lot of conflict in relationship. I know we are talking about marital or love relationship here, but this could also impact on even other forms of relationship, for example, like business relationship or even career relationship.
So when we talk about intellectual compatibility, you have to come to a point where the person you want to settle down with, both of you can communicate at the same or similar level.
Mm.
You have things you can share, you talk about, you, in fact, you can spend a whole day talking and you're not bored. You have that level of
connection
and compatibility. I remember before we got married, you know, we could be on the phone, we talk about a lot of things, probably because we had similar exposure.
But I think that people in relationships, a lot of people, they'll have this, and then they get married and then they suddenly find out that it's
not there anymore.
Yes.
I think we did an episode where we talked about growing apart in marriage.
Mm.
And we said one of the reasons that one person is growing, one person is upskilling himself, developing himself, getting more exposure, while the other person is just there, not doing so much.
Yeah.
So in this case, you can meet someone whose intellectual capacity is not at the same level with you.
Yes.
But then if that's flexibility,
yes,
where you want to grow, you want to educate yourself more, it can be balanced.
Yeah. So how do you test that you both are compatible intellectually? No, we've talked about this before, but there are certain questions that you may need to ask yourself, I mean, for a fact. Do you have common interests in your values, in your belief system that allow the similarity in your worldview, such as that you're able to engage in
meaningful
deep level of conversation with each other?
Very important, you know.
And I think another thing is, do you trust the intelligence of the other person? So when you're seeking information, are you the go-to person that I can have that conversation?
What do you think?
Yes.
You know, those kind of questions, you know. Yeah, you are right. If I don't trust that you're intellectually, you know, at the same level with me,
or even could be more,
then
I wouldn't even come to you. I wouldn't seek information. I can't trust that, you know, you're intelligent enough to tell me something. And you know.
So knowing that we are intellectually compatible involves knowing that I respect your view.
Yes.
I respect that you have so much to offer in terms of information.
Yes.
And we can have that dialogue or conversation in a very relaxed manner.
Yes.
And we're happy with each other.
Absolutely. Now, if people out there say, oh, then I'm not in that category, what do I do? I think that it's not a bad point to be, because you kind of come to the realization that you need help.
Yeah, but the thing is that, let's point this out, compatibility has levels.
Yes.
So it depends on your level. You choose someone who can flow alongside you. That is the key thing. It doesn't have to make you feel, I need to go to university, I need to do this, I
need
to do that.
Yes.
Make a choice based on someone that can flow with you at the same level.
Absolutely. I think that this is a good point that you've made, because now a lot of people might be having a lot of insecurity issues and saying, oh, I feel less of myself because I am not compatible intellectually. So, good point.
It's about who you're relating with.
Yes. Now, another thing that is touching on is, are you ready to learn?
Yeah.
Are you ready to relearn? Are you ready to unlearn? Because some people say, oh no, this is the way I think, this is the way I reason. But you also need to think about that there's a lot of changing tides, and you also need to grow together so you don't grow apart in your relationship.
Yeah.
So I would say that it is very important that you are flexible. So flexibility is key.
Yeah, flexibility not just for the person who thinks he or she is higher intellectually. Flexibility in terms of the person who wants to grow.
Yeah.
So you might not be at the same path now, but if there is flexibility, you too can compromise and, you know, blend as you go along. Someone out there may be wondering, why are we emphasizing intellectual compatibility? You think it's not important. Mm. But for us, we know intellectual compatibility makes communication effective. And mind you, communication is the life wire of any relationship. If you cannot communicate effectively and at the same level or similar level, the marriage or the relationship becomes a struggle.
The next compatibility test we want to touch on is social compatibility. Mm. Now, this is an area where I think it's a lot of people struggle with. Mm-hmm. But in some relationships, some people have been able to figure this out. So when you think about, do we have similar friends? Mm-hmm. Do we have similar worldview? Are we proud to be in each other's company in public? Mm. Not in private, in public.
In public, yeah.
Some individuals are not proud to introduce their spouse to your friends.
I can tell anyone who cares to know that you are my wife. I'm so proud of you anywhere. But then there are people who can't do that.
Yeah, some people actually feel awkward.
I see that even on social media where someone is married, you can't even see the person's spouse. Mm. The person can introduce
They might have a reason for that. Because some people don't want private, their life on social media. Yes, so let me just put that there. Some people might have a reason for not putting their family or putting their spouse on social media.
But there are also people who are not proud.
Yes, that's the point. The point is, are you proud of your spouse? Yes. Do you feel awkward when you're in each other's company in public and you know people get to see you? Are you proud to introduce your partner to your family members? You know, without any sense of fear or shame or even embarrassment, because some people get embarrassed when they have to introduce, you know, their would-be person to their family.
Yeah, so the point is, if you want to introduce someone or you want to make a choice of who to get married to, and you look at that person, you feel awkward being around the person. You feel a sense of shame, a sense of embarrassment.
Yes.
Then you guys are not socially compatible.
Yeah. So now, would you say now, because you're not socially compatible, you shouldn't get married?
If you can walk your way through it and, you know, solve that problem for whatever reason, you're not socially compatible, then it's fine. But if you know that this is what is going to be long term, then you have to think about it. I also think that social compatibility is interlinked with the next compatibility test we want to look at, which is physical compatibility. Are you physically compatible with someone you want to get married to? Physical compatibility is important for some people, even though it may sound superficial talking about it here, but then you have to be sure that you guys are physically attracted to each other, not in terms of sex, so to speak, but you know you're happy with what you see, you're happy with this person, you feel connected with this person, because even emotional connection, all those are linked to physical compatibility.
But then it shouldn't be the reason for you getting married alone. So you actually need to look at this test.
In fact, it's secondary.
Yes.
But it's also important to look at that compatibility, because if you're not proud of someone, if you don't feel okay with how someone looks, how someone dresses, it can be upgraded, it can be changed if the person is flexible.
Yeah.
If you think someone is, allow me to use the word dirty, then it becomes a problem for you. Some people have, you know, bad hygiene.
Yeah.
They don't dress well. They don't take good care of themselves. There is this other person who is so clean, so perfect. Everywhere is clean.
Yeah, I see.
So for that person, living with the other person will be an issue.
Yes, yes.
Because so you have to check that.
Yeah.
And see if this is what you can
For some people, this might be something that is not there right now. Mm. But as long as you're flexible enough, you're willing enough to work on it, then fine. Mm. That may be worked on, but I would say that it's something that needs checking out. So that you don't find yourself in a relationship with someone that you don't feel proud of.
Yes.
Because compatibility is a very important element in deciding who you settle down with. Mm-hmm. We've highlighted some of those, but you can still tell us other forms of compatibility that probably we have missed out on. So you maybe probably put your comments and let us know what you think.
Of all the compatibility tests we've looked at, we believe that spiritual compatibility is primary. It is core. Every other compatibility can be worked on if you're flexible.
Yeah.
But spiritual compatibility cannot be taken for granted.
For granted, yes. And I think that's the case. I mean, let us know your views. Let us know your thoughts. It would be great to hear from you. Your feedback, please put your comments below. Mm. If you love what we're doing, like the video, share it, you know, with friends and people you think will find value in this. And I would say to our returning subscribers, thank you for always sticking with the content that we're constantly putting out. And we love you. We see all you do. If you're new to our channel, please do not forget, hit the subscribe button, turn on your notification bell, and I'm sure that you would not regret it, because we would always come with content that you would find valuable. And until the next episode, we have to go, sadly, but we have to. It's goodbye from us. Goodbye.